Hello, Sophie here. I'm a grease pencil artist who mainly works in 2D, but lately I've been challenging myself to learn more about the other tools in Blender. If you're like me, and geometry nodes sound super intimidating and scary, this series is meant to share my honest journey learning this tool as a complete beginner, and to hopefully dispel some of that mystery surrounding it in a fun way. This month, my focus is on instancing grease pencil objects to curves. The magic of curve instancing is that you can actually draw curves that will turn into an array of artworks. And what I ended up finding is that instancing to curves actually offers me a lot more control over the geometry node instances than with my previous methods that I've tried. Which was instancing to just a mesh. So yeah, I am so excited to share this. First up, I'll be sharing the node setup for these snowflake instances. This was very basic, just dipping my toes into curve instancing. And then I started to add some complexity to my node setup to make these flower instances. And here is where the magic really starts. So any tutorials that I follow are always linked below. And my final blend files of these artworks that I share in these videos are free to download. And if bonus content interests you, I got you covered. Also, just check below. Let's go! First up, to create the snowflakes themselves, I'll add a new grease pencil blank object. So in draw mode, I'll keep my stroke placement at the 3D cursor, but I want to draw along the side, just because that's the orientation that I'm currently looking at my scene from. Over here, I'll right-click to make a new collection for these objects before I forget. Then I'll use the ink pen brush. This will allow me to have fully opaque strokes, but with variations in line thickness. And I'll also pick a white vertex color. I think I'll add a mirror modifier to mirror my strokes. Okay, on second thought, the mirror modifier probably isn't the best for this. Because actually, I want to go for six-sided snowflakes, so I think maybe I'm actually better off using an array modifier to rotate my strokes around the center. So what I can do, I can make the count six. Then in object mode, I want to add an empty. So for the array modifier, I can turn on object offset. And I want to select this empty as the target object. Then in object mode, I can rotate the empty along the x-axis. And so to get an even spread for these six arms, I want to rotate it 360 divided by six. So that's 60 degrees. And beautiful! Okay, now I can just draw designs onto one of these arms, and that will affect all of the arms. So normally when I'm making different grease pencil objects to use as instances, I tend to duplicate an object and move the new copy to the side. But for this, it's a bit tricky, because I can't move the snowflake objects to the side without messing up the array offset. So what I can do, I can either apply the array modifier and then move the snowflake object, or I can just make the duplicates hidden while I work on different snowflakes. For now, I think I'll take the route of just hiding the snowflakes because I don't know how they'll look in my scene once I create the geometry nodes, and I may want to still modify them. I love these. So yeah, making them all visible. I can't really see how they look side by side. They're just one big blob hiding one another, but it's fine. It'll show up as soon as I set up my nodes. Now for the geometry nodes, I will add a Bezier curve, I guess? I don't think it matters specifically which type of curve I add, basically just some curve. Make sure it's outside of my snowflake collection, then give it geometry nodes, instances on points, and drag in our snowflake collection to add as our instances. Pick instance, and also check on these boxes. And this is looking good. In the blend file I downloaded from this tutorial, I noticed that he uses a resample curve node in between the first node and the instance on points node. So I guess I'll try adding this. Oh, that's pretty cool. I wonder if this does the equivalent as the distribute points on faces node, which I used to scatter the instances along an object. Like, does this do the equivalent function just for a curve? I want to check. So if I try to use the node that I've previously used, it's called distribute points on faces. What happens? Okay, it indeed doesn't work on curves. So my understanding is that with this setup, in edit mode of my curve, I can use the draw curve tool to create new lines of snowflakes. So if I look through my camera now and draw in where I wanted these snowflakes to go, we are having some major sizing issues for one thing. Let me scale down these snowflakes. And also if I toy with the length value a bit, this is looking nice. I think I'd like some variation in the scale. So I can do that with a random value node plugged into the scale value. And I'm still not sure about the sizing. Maybe I want all the snowflakes to be a bit smaller. I wish I knew how to change the seed of the snowflakes. Like to randomize which ones are showing up at which points on each curve. I'm able to affect it somewhat by moving the points of my curves in edit mode. And it seems like the strokes I drew first are affecting the instant snowflakes of all the curves I drew afterwards. Another thing I just noticed, these snowflakes all follow the order in which my snowflakes are numbered in my collection. Yeah, that is not random at all, and I don't know how to randomize this. One last thing. So I want to do a kind of very simple way of animating the scale of these snowflakes. I don't know if you saw my last video, but I had a very complex node setup that I used to animate the randomized scale of the waves. So this is not that. So I basically just animated the seed value of this random node plugged into the scale. At frame 1, it's keyframed at 0, and then at frame 250, it's keyframed at a seed of 50. So this results in a jittery animation of the snowflakes because they're basically being assigned a new random scale value every 5 frames. Okay, so my goal now is to figure out how to better control curves within geometry nodes. What I love so far about the curve method is being able to draw the specific shapes of the curves where I want the nodes to show up. It feels so magical to draw a line and to have that turn into art. But I don't like that there's no randomness and that I can't change the order of the instances. So far, I have not found a way to achieve this using the original curves themselves. If you have any information on how this might be possible, any resources to learn more about curves, I had trouble finding that, I would appreciate any input. The solution that I did find is to turn the curve into a mesh, at which point the node setup becomes pretty similar to what I've created in the past. So far for this piece, my node setup looks like this. My goal is to have a wreath of flowers around this pet portrait. So currently I just have that on this mesh disc that I created with geometry nodes. This setup is similar to what I did last month. So I have these two meshes, a cylinder and a circle, and I use a mesh Boolean node to have one mesh create empty space in the other mesh. But ultimately, I wanted more control over the placement of the florals. I was even starting to think it might look better to have the wreath elements placed unevenly around my portrait. A big inspiration for me is this artist, Julia Libard, who makes these pet portraits surrounded by flowers so beautiful. And I was really admiring these partial wreaths that they draw, and I did want to try something similar. And I think this time, also inspired by this artist, I am going to go for geometry nodes that are just flowers. I'll add any stems and leaves separately at the end. So I'm drawing with stroke placement at origin. That's this orange dot here, and I'm trying to line it up with the center of my flower. I'm drawing along the front plane, so the flowers will all be flat and facing forward. I want to add a fill material, which is just a solid fill, and then on a new layer, I'll use that to outline the shape of my flower. And then I'll be masking my color layer to this base so that the strokes I use to render the flower will never go past this base. All right, I think this is a nice collection to start from. So now I'll set up the geometry nodes. First up, though, I'll quickly clean up my flower collection. Now, just out of curiosity, I'll plug this collection into the curve node setup that I've been experimenting with, and then I'll explain the setup itself. Okay, this is really cute so far. Another thing I like about this node setup is that, remember how with my snowflake curves, if I modified the curve geometry in edit mode, it would also modify the instances of all of the curves that had been drawn after the curve that I am modifying? So I was not a huge fan of that effect. And now, modifying any curve won't touch any of the other curves. Amazing. Oh, interesting. Okay, but it is still the case that if I delete a curve segment, that does randomize all of the instances. But now, let me explain my node setup. So I started by adding a Bezier curve object. And so this first node is just showing the curve geometry. When I draw a curve, it technically looks like this at first. The resample curve node moves around the geometry of the curves. I'll use my original snowflakes to illustrate this, since the snowflake instances each represent a point on the curve. So the length setting spreads out these points based on a length. The instances are always equally spaced apart. The count setting makes so that each curve segment has the same number of points. They'll just be very close together or more spaced out depending on the length of the curve. And I honestly don't know what evaluated does. No idea what this means. So a few videos later, I'm still not sure. And I'm not noticing much of a difference. There is some difference, sometimes. So this note was just in my file kind of as a leftover because I copy-pasted over from that file. So I think in this case, I'll just get rid of it. Also, side note, I am really enjoying being able to modify which instances show up by modifying the points of the curves. And I'm able to modify specific instances without having to modify all of the other curve instances too. If you saw last month's video, I talked about how I didn't really have a way to modify specific instances. My only solution was one random. It was to change the seed of the distribute points on faces node, and it also randomized absolutely every instance in my scene. So actually, maybe using curves to instance grease pencil objects is even better than just using a mesh or a grid, because I have never had control like this, being able to move around specific instances or replace them, and I think I'm hooked. I'm able to modify the instances by selecting either the endpoints of the curves or the two handles to either side of them. Same goes for points in the middle of the curve. And then if I want to move a group of instances without modifying them, to just like reposition them, I can do that by selecting one point of a curve, and then in the select dropdown, I can select linked. That's also the shortcut Control L. So that's really helpful, and now I can move this group of flowers around with G. Oh, I don't know why, but rotating a curve changes the instances. What is happening? This is so much fun. All right, I got so sidetracked. Sorry, let me explain my node tree now. So basically after our curve geometry, I have a curve to mesh node. It's my understanding that on its own, we won't see anything because a curve doesn't have any thickness. And so the mesh that gets created essentially has no thickness. That's why I've also added a curve circle node, plugged it into the profile curve of the curve to mesh node, and then by setting it to radius, this allows me to control the thickness of the meshes that get created from these curves. So at this point, we no longer have curves, but meshes. So I can treat the instance setup in the same way as I've done before, which means next up, I have a distribute points on faces node. This spreads points onto a mesh, and we can control the density, and the seed just randomizes them differently. And each of these points is what becomes a geometry node instance when plugged into the instance on points node. Also, like I did with my snowflakes, I can add this random value node to have the scale of my flowers be randomized between two values. Alright, so that's gonna be it for this video. Instancing to curves really surprised me, and I don't think I'll go back to instancing just to mesh objects. I think this is way cooler. So thank you so much for watching and for following along on my learning journey. As always, I have so much fun putting these videos together, so I hope that this was helpful. Have you been learning geometry nodes, or would you like to? Or have you already mastered it? Let me know, I'm so curious. If you have been wanting to give it a try, and like me, feel super intimidated, I honestly say just go for it. After 3 months now, only 3 months, the scariness has completely passed, and it is just so cool and so much fun to play around with this tool. So I will see you again very soon. Take care. Bye.